Welcome everybody once again. So we are in our last class for module 3. So today we will try to solve some 5 problems on pipes in series and parallel and equivalent pipes. So already we have seen the concept for equivalent pipes and pipes connected in series and parallel in the previous classes. Today we try to solve a few problems related to that concept. So the first problem is the difference in surface levels in 2 tanks which are connected by 3 pipes in series of length 300 meter, 170 meter and 210 meter and of diameter 30 centimeter, 20 centimeter and 40 centimeter respectively is 12 meter. So what are the things given in your problem? You have 2 different tanks. So the water level, the surface water level of the 2 tanks, the difference in the surface water level of the 2 tanks. So this is tank 1 and this is tank 2. So this difference is, so the difference in water surface levels is 12 meter. So this difference is 12 meter. Okay, the difference in water surface level in 2 tanks is 12 meter. And it is given that these 2 tanks are connected by 3 pipes in series. So you have 3 pipes, 1, 2 and 3. You have 3 pipes connected in series of length 300 meter, 170 meter and 210 meter and of diameter 30 centimeter, 20 centimeter and 40 centimeter respectively. Determine the rate of flow of water. So we need to find what is Q if coefficient of a friction R, that is F, coefficient of friction is taken as F, small f, are 0.005, 0.0052 and 0.0048 respectively. That means for the first pipe it is 0.005, for the second pipe it is 0.0052 and for third pipe it is 0.0048. So considering, so we need to find Q by considering minor losses by neglecting the minor losses. So we will see how to solve this problem. So we need to find the rate of flow of water by considering the minor losses and by neglecting the minor losses. Now, first of all, let us try to draw the diagram. Okay, so we have 2 tanks. So we will try to draw 2 tanks. So this is tank 1. And we will draw another tank here. So this is tank 2. Okay, so these tanks are connected by pipes. So first pipe is of greater length, next is 170, next is 210. Before that, the difference in the surface levels. This is the water surface level. Here this can be assumed as the water surface level. So the difference between these 2 levels, so this difference is given as 12 meter. Difference in the water surface levels between the 2 tanks is given as 12 meter. Now the 3 pipes of length 300 meter. So this 300 meter length pipe is of diameter 30 centimeter. So a 30 centimeter pipe, so here D1 is equal to 30 centimeter and length L1 is equal to 300 meter for the first pipe. So 300 meter. Now the second pipe is of diameter 20 centimeter and length is 170 meter. So second pipe diameter is 20 centimeter and length is 170 meter. And what about the third pipe? The third pipe is of diameter 40 centimeter and length is 210 meter. So D3 is equal to 40 centimeter and L3 is equal to 210 meter. So these are the given data. Okay, so the given data are the difference in the water level. H is given as 12 meter. D1 is 30 centimeter, that is equal to 0.3 meter. And L1 is equal to 300 meter. D2 is equal to 20 centimeter, that is equal to 0.2 meter. And L2 is equal to 170 meter. D3 is equal to 40 centimeter, that is equal to 0.4 meter, and L3 is equal to 210 meter. Now, determine the rate of flow of water if coefficients of friction, that is coefficient of friction in the three pipes, F1 is given as 0.005. F2 is given as 0.0052 and F3 is given as 0.0048. So we need to determine what is Q. Find what is Q. Case 1, consider the minor losses also, and case 2, neglect the minor losses. So first of all, we will go for case 1. So case 1. Considering the minor losses also. So when we are considering the minor losses also, we know for major loss, the formula for H, that is hydraulic losses, the formula for losses is 4FLV² / 2GD. And minor losses, considering the different conditions, we have different equations. So before that, see, we have three different pipes with three different diameters and three different lengths. So first of all, we will use the continuity equation. So we know the continuity equation for pipes is A1V1 is equal to A2V2 is equal to A3V3. So now we will write this V2 in terms of V1 and V3 in terms of V1. So considering these two equations, A1V1 is equal to A2V2, we get, so we are taking these both, A1V1 is equal to A2V2, we get V2 is equal to A1V1 / A2. So that is equal to A1. A1 is pi D1 square by 4 into V1 divided by A2 is pi D2 square divided by 4. So we can cancel this pi pi 4 4. What we get is D1 by D2 the whole square into V1, from which we get V2 is equal to, see, substituting the value for D1 is 0.3 meter. Okay, we'll write that also. So that is equal to D1 is 0.3 meter. So 0.3 divided by D2 is 0.2. The whole square into V1. So from which we get V2 is equal to 2.25 V1. Similarly, we will take these two equations, that is A2, V2. We will consider the equations A2, V2 is equal to A3, V3. What we get is, sorry, we take these both, A1, V1 is equal to A3, V3. A1, V1 is equal to A3, V3. So from which we get V3 is equal to A3 by A1 into V1. So we get A3 is pi D3 square by 4 into V1 divided by A1 is pi D1 square divided by 4. So from which we get D3 by D1 V3 is A1 V1 by A3. So this is A1, A3. So we get D1, D3. So D1 by D3 the whole square into V1. So D1 is 0.3 divided by D3. The diameter D3 is 0.4 meter. So 0.3 divided by 0.4 the whole square into V1. So from which we get V3 is equal to 0.5625 V1. Now we will find the losses. So we have to consider both major loss as well as the minor loss. So now what are the major losses? So first, so H is equal to, the losses H is equal to, we have three pipes and the coefficient of a friction for the three pipes are given. That means we have minor losses. We have losses due to friction in all the three pipes. So the formula for losses due to friction is, we know 4FL V square by 2GD. So we have three pipes. So it is 4F1 L1 V1 square by 2GD1. For the pipe 2, it is 4F2 L2 V2 square by 2GD2 plus 4F3 L3 V3 square by 2GD3. Now the major losses are over. Now we have to go for the minor losses. So what are the minor losses? So we have already studied the minor losses. The minor losses are due to the loss of head due to sudden enlargement, loss of head due to sudden contraction, loss of head at the entrance of the pipe, loss of head at the exit of the pipe, loss of head due to an obstruction in the pipe, loss of head due to the bend in the pipe, and loss of head due to various pipe fittings. So first of all, we will consider the loss of head due to the entrance of the pipe. Why we are considering the loss of head due to the entrance of the pipe? See, here there is entrance, right? So we will consider from this tank water is entering through this pipe. So here there is entrance. So at this point we have loss of head due to entrance of the pipe. So loss of head due to entrance of the pipe is given as 0.5 V square by 2G. So here it is entering to the pipe V1, so it is 0.5 V1 square by 2G. Then when it enter from this pipe to this pipe, from this pipe to this pipe, we have again loss of head due to entrance of the pipe. So that will be equal to 0.5 V2 square by 2G. Again, when entering from this pipe to this pipe, it is 0.5 V3 square by 2G. Now we have another minor loss due to the sudden enlargement of the pipe. Okay. So loss of head due to sudden enlargement of the pipe is given as here. Loss of head due to sudden enlargement. So it is V2 minus V3 the whole square by 2G. So we have four minor losses. Here loss due to entrance of the pipe, loss due to entrance of the pipe, loss due to entrance of the pipe, and loss due to sudden enlargement. See, here also you have losses due to sudden contraction. But it is necessary to take only one, either due to sudden contraction or due to the entrance of the pipe. So for both the formula remains the same, that is 0.5 V2 square by 2G. You can consider this as due to sudden contraction of the pipe or due to the entrance of water through the pipe. So now we will write the formula. So the minor losses are, so the first minor loss is due to the entrance of the water in the pipe, 1. So it is 0.5 V1 square by 2G plus it is a sudden contraction from the pipe 1 to 2 or the entrance through the pipe 2. So it is again 0.5 V2 square by 2G plus the entrance of the pipe, water from the entrance, water entering from the pipe 2 to 3. So it is 0.5 V3 square by 2G. Now, due to sudden enlargement from pipe 2 to 3, it is V2 minus V3 the whole square by 2G. Now we will substitute all the values and we will find what is H. But actually it is given H, that is the losses. This difference in the surface level means that is nothing but the losses. So we know H is 12 is equal to 4. F1 is 0.005 into L1 is 300 meter into V1 square. V1 square, you will take it as V1 square divided by 2 into 9.81 into D1 is 0.3 plus you can substitute all the values. Okay, we have already found all the values, write V1, V2 and V3 in terms of V1. So the only unknown will be V1, from which, see, substitute all the values, okay, substitute all the values from which we get, the only unknown will be V1. So V1 is equal to 1.445 meter per second. So once you know V1, you can find what is Q. You know Q is equal to A1 V1, from which we get Q is equal to pi D1 square by 4 into V1, which is equal to pi by 4 into D1 is 0.3. 30 centimeter. The diameter of the pipe 1 is 30 centimeter. So converting it into meter, 0.3 square into V1 is 1.445 meter per second, from which you get Q is equal to 102.1. Okay, before that you will get Q is equal to 0.1021 meter cube per second. Converting it into liters per second, you get Q is equal to 102.1 liters per second. For converting meter cube to liters, multiply it by 1000. So, very simple problem. Hope you understood. We will move on to the next problem. The next problem is three pipes of length 800 meter, 500 meter and 400 meter are of diameters 50 centimeter, 40 centimeter and 30 centimeter respectively, are connected in series. These pipes are to be replaced by a single pipe of length 1700 meter. Find the diameter of the single pipe. So, single pipe is nothing but your equivalent pipe. You are asked to find the diameter of the equivalent pipe. So, it is given three pipes of length 800 meter. So, 800 meter length pipe is of diameter 50 centimeter. So, D1 is 50 centimeter, that is equal to 0.5 meter. And length is equal to 800 meter. Pipe 2, the length is 500 meter and the diameter is 40 centimeter, right? So the diameter is reduced to 40 centimeter. And the length is, so L2 is equal to 500 meter and D2 is equal to 40 centimeter, that is 0.4 meter. And the third pipe is of diameter 30 centimeter. Again, it is reduced to 30 centimeter and the length is 400 meter. So, L3 is 400 meter and D3 is 30 centimeter, that is equal to 0.3 meter. They are connected in series. You are asked to find a single pipe, equivalent pipe. So this pipe is replaced by a, if this pipe is replaced by an equivalent pipe of length 1700 meter. So now it is 800 1700 meter, equivalent length of 1700 meter. What can be the diameter? So we know that the formula for the relationship between the pipes connected in series and equivalent pipe, we know the relation is L by D raised to 5. That is, this is the length of the equivalent pipe. D is the diameter of the equivalent pipe, will be equal to L1 by D1 raised to 5 plus L2 by D2 raised to 5 plus L3 by D3 raised to 5. So, I am not explaining everything. You can substitute. I have given you the values. All the values are known. L is also known. So, you can substitute the values and you can take the answer. You will get the diameter of the equivalent pipe small d is equal to 37.18 centimeter. So, you will get d is equal to 0.3718 meter. You can convert it into centimeter. You get 37.18 centimeter. See, very simple. You solve this problem. Very important for examination point of view. Next problem. The third problem. Okay, a main pipe divides into two parallel pipes, which again forms one pipe as shown in the figure. So, you have one main pipe, it is getting divided into two parallel pipes. Then, which again forms one pipe as shown in the figure. Again, it is forming into one pipe. Okay. So, single pipe branched into two parallel pipes. Then again, it is forming a single pipe. The length and diameter of the first parallel pipe are 2000 meter and 1 meter respectively. So, the length is 2000 meter and the diameter is 1 meter. So, for the first parallel pipe, length L1 is equal to 2000 meter and diameter D1 is equal to 1 meter. While the length and diameter of the second parallel pipe are 2000 meter and 0.8 meter. So, L2 is equal to 2000 meter and D2 is equal to 0.8 meter. Find the rate of flow in each parallel pipe. So, we need to find what is Q1, what is Q2. If total flow in the main pipe is 3 meter cube per second. Here, in the main pipe, Q is equal to 3 meter cube per second. The coefficient of friction for each parallel pipe is same and is equal to 0.005. That means our F1, it is given F1 is equal to F2 is equal to 0.005. Now we need to find what is Q1 and we need to find what is Q2. Now, see, we know from the continuity equation, and if the pipe is branched into two parallel pipes, we know the discharge Q will be equal to Q1 plus Q2. Q is equal to, this is Q1, this is 2, this is 1, this is 2. So, Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2. This discharge is equal to discharge in the first parallel pipe plus discharge in the second parallel pipe. And it is given Q is equal to 3. So Q1 plus Q2 is equal to 3. The other important things given are the length and diameter and the frictional coefficients. So we will consider the losses. It is given the coefficient of friction is the same for two pipes. So the losses due to friction will be same in the two pipes. So from which we get, if the losses of a friction is the same in the two pipes, we get the losses due to friction, that is 4F1 L1 V1 square by 2GD1 is equal to 4F2 L2 V2 square by 2GD2. Now we can substitute the values 4 into, see F1 is the same. So we can cancel F1, F2. We can cancel this 4, 4. This 2, 2. GG, F1, F2. Because F1 is equal to F2. L1 and L2 is also same. You can cancel these both. So what we get is V1 square by D1 is equal to V2 square by D2. So from which we get V1 square by D1 is 1 meter is equal to V2 square by 0.8. So from this we get V1 is equal to V2 by 0.894. So if you know V1, now you can take this. See, Q1 is equal to A1 V1. And Q2 will be equal to A2 V2. Now we will consider this equation. We will take this as equation number 1. So substituting these in equation number 1, we get Q1 is A1 V1 plus Q2 is A2 V2 is equal to 3. From which A1 is pi into D1 square by 4 into V1. Plus pi into D2 square by 4 into V2 is equal to 3. So from which we get pi into D1. D1 is 1 meter. So 1 square divided by 4 into V1 plus pi into D2. D2 is 0.8. 0.8 square divided by 4 into V2. So we have obtained V1 in terms of V2. So V2 is equal to 0.894 V1 is equal to 3. From which we get V1 is equal to 2.427 meter per second. So if we know V1, we can easily find V2. So V2 is equal to 0.894 V1, from which we get V2 is equal to 2.17 meter per second. Now we can find Q1 and Q2. So Q1 is equal to A1 V1 is equal to pi into D1 square by 4 into V1. Substituting the values, we get Q1 is equal to 1.906 meter cube per second, and Q2 is equal to A2V2. You can write pi D2 square by 4 into V2 is equal to 1.094 meter cube per second. You can also find this in other way. You can use either Q2 is equal to A2V2, or you can use Q2 is equal to Q minus Q1. Okay, Q2 is equal to Q minus Q1. Use any of this equation. You will find, you will obtain Q1, that is flow in the first parallel pipe and rate of flow in the second parallel pipe. We will move on to the fourth problem. So the fourth problem is a pipeline of 0.6 meter diameter is 1.5 kilometer long. So you have a pipeline. So this pipeline is, length of this pipeline is 1.5 kilometer. That is nothing but 1500 meter. To increase the discharge, another line of same diameter is, okay, the diameter is given as 0.6 meter. To increase the discharge, another line of the same diameter is introduced parallel to the first in the second half of the length. So in order to increase the discharge, see this total length is 1500 meter. So from half of the length, another line of same diameter is introduced parallel to the first in the second half of the length. So in the second half of the length, this is the second half, okay? So second half of the length, another parallel pipe of same diameter is introduced. Introduced parallelly. So the diameter of this parallel pipe is also 0.6 meter. So this distance is now 750 meter. So the first half is 750 meter. And the second half is 750 meter. So totally 1500 meter. Neglecting minor losses. So you are neglecting the minor losses. Find the increase in discharge if 4F is equal to 0.04. The head at inlet is 30 centimeter. So at the inlet, the head is given as 30 centimeter. So that means at inlet, you will have a tank. You will have a reservoir at the inlet where the head at the reservoir is 30 centimeter. So this is 30 centimeter. So that is equal to 0.3 meter. Okay. So how will we solve this problem? So it is given 4F is equal to 0.04, from which we get F is equal to 0.01. So head at the inlet is given as 0.3 meter, which means this inlet, head at inlet is measured from the center line of the pipe. So which means head at outlet is equal to 0, which is the atmospheric head. Okay, so head at outlet is the atmospheric head. So, if it is atmospheric head, head at outlet will be equal to 0. Now, we will find what is the major loss, right? Find the increase in discharge and neglecting the minor losses. So, our losses is HF is our loss due to friction is 4FLV square by 2GD. So, HF is given as 0.3 meter, 30 centimeter. Because, see here the head is 0. At inlet, the head is 0. At the outlet, the head, sorry, at inlet, the head is 0.3. At the outlet, head is 0. Okay? Head at inlet is equal to 0.3 meter. That is 30 centimeter. So, HF, total losses is 0.3 minus 0, you get 0.3 meter. So, total loss is 0.3 meter is equal to 4 into F is 0.01 coefficient of friction into L. The total length of the pipe is 1500 into V square divided by 2 into 9.81 into D. The diameter of the pipe is same. So, it is 0.6. So, from which, so the only unknown is velocity V, mean velocity V, we get mean velocity V is equal to 0.2426 meter per second. So, if we understand V, we can find Q. So, Q is equal to V into area. So, V is 0.2426. Area is, the diameter is 0.6. So, pi by 4 into 0.6 square, we get 0.0685 meter cube per second. Okay. See, now we have considered this. That is, by considering the pipe as a single pipe. Because we have taken this length as 1500 meter. So, what we have solved so far is without considering this pipe, without considering this parallel pipe. Now, without considering this parallel pipe, the head at the outlet, head at outlet. So, okay, without considering the parallel pipe, your discharge is equal to 0.0685. Now, we need to find what is the discharge, or what is the increase in discharge, because of additional of this parallel pipe also. So, second case we will consider, we will consider it as case 2. So, we will consider after the addition of the parallel pipe. So, after the addition of the parallel pipe, what is happening? So, we know this discharge is Q. Q is equal to, here the discharge is Q, right? Here the discharge is Q. So, this get divided into Q1 and Q2. So, we can take this as Q1, D1, diameter, L1. And here it is Q2, D2 and L2. So, what we get is we know Q will be equal to Q1 plus Q2. Now, the length and diameter of these two pipes are the same. The length and diameter of these two pipes are same. 750 meter length, the diameter is 0.6. So, if the length and diameter of the two pipe is same, we get, since the diameter and length is same for both the parallel pipes, Q1 will be equal to Q2. So which means Q1 is equal to Q2 is equal to Q by 2. Okay. Now we will consider the flow through the pipe through the two. We will give some names. Okay. So in order to differentiate, we will give the names as we will take this point as A, this as B, C, and this point is D. So we will consider the main pipe as A, B, C, then A, B, D. So now the head loss through A, B, C will be equal to head loss through A, B plus head loss through B, C. But we know the head lost due to friction through the pipe ABC will be equal to this 0.3 meter. That is nothing but we have already found when there is a single pipe, the pressure at the outlet is atmospheric pressure 0, pressure at inlet is 0.3 meter. So the total losses will be 0.3 meter. So that means, so head lost through ABC, that is through the main pipe ABC, right? Head loss through ABC will be equal to head loss through AB plus head loss through BC. So head loss through AB plus head lost through BC. Now, we know the total head loss through ABC is 0.3 meter. Now, so head lost through AB will be equal to 4F, F is the same, 4F L1 V1 square by 2G D1 plus 4F L2 V2 square by 2G D2. Now we know velocity is equal to Q is equal to AB. So velocity is equal to Q by A. Okay, so now we will substitute these values. We get is equal to 4 into F. F is given as 0.01. So 0.01 into L is 750 divided by 2 into 9.81 into D is 0.6. D1 into V1 square. So what is V1 square? Q by So Q divided by area is pi D1 square by 4. So 0.6 the whole square into 4. Plus 4 into F is 0.01. Okay, so V1 is equal to Q1 by area. So what is Q1? Q by 2. Q by 2 divided by area. So Q by 2A. Okay, so V1 square is this is Q1, right? Okay. Q1, okay, V1 square. So square Q by so Q1 can be replaced by, see, I will write this once again. Okay, this is 4F L1 by 2G D1 into, we need V1 square. So V1 square is Q by 2 times A1. So A1 is pi into D1 square by 4. So the whole square. Plus 4 into F is 0.01 into L2 is 750 divided by 2 into 9.81 into again D2 is 0.6 multiplied by V2 square. So V2 also will be equal to Q by 2A2. So Q by 2 times A2 is pi D2, that is 0.6 the whole square into 4, it is V2 square. So here the only unknown is Q, so from which we get Q is equal to 0.0867 meter cube per second. So initially, without the addition of the parallel pipe, our Q is 0.0685 meter cube per second. So the increase in discharge is equal to 0.0867 minus 0.0685, that is equal to 0.0182 meter cube per second. This is the increase in discharge. So now we will move on to our last problem, fifth problem. So this problem is, see, you can solve it of your own. A pumping plant forces water through a 60 centimeter diameter main, the frictional head being 27 meter, so H is 27 meter. In order to reduce the power consumption, it is proposed to lay another main of appropriate diameter along the side of the existing one, so that two pipes may work in parallel for the entire length and reduce the friction head to 9.6 meter only. So your friction head is reduced from 27 meter to 9.6 meter. Find the diameter of the two main if, with the exception of diameter, it is similar to the existing one in every respect. Okay, so you have a single main. So you will have a single main. See, I am just giving you the idea. You do this as a practice problem. Then it is branching into two pipes. Okay, it is branching into two pipes. So this is a single main. The diameter is a 0.6 meter. And HF is equal to 27 meter. That is, head lost is 27 meter. Now when it is, okay, we'll do it in another way. See, you have a pumping plant. The discharge, you have diameter as a 0.6 meter and HF is equal to 27 meter. Then next, in order to reduce the power consumption, it is proposed to lay another main of appropriate diameter along the side of the existing one. So that it is laid like this. So this is Q. This can be divided into Q1 and Q2. The diameter is D1 is 0.6 meter and D2 is also 0.6 meter. And HF is given as 9.6 meter. Here the head loss for this case. See, for this case the head loss is 27 meter. For this case the head loss is 9.6 meter. So you can use for the single main. For this case HF is equal to 4FLV² / 2GD. So HF is 27 meter. Substitute, you will get see the unknowns are F, L and V. The unknowns will be F, L, V. So write V in terms of Q by A. So you get F, L, V is Q by A, right? So Q by A the whole square, you will get the value as 79.461. Okay, these are the unknowns. Now you can consider the second case. So second case, you will have HF1, head loss in the first parallel pipe and head loss in the second parallel pipe. That is HF2. So you will get HF1, you can substitute it as 4FLV² / 2GD1, and for HF2, 4FL2V² / 2GD2. So HF1 is 9.6. So D1, diameter D1 is 0.6. Here the diameter D is also 0.6. So substitute for the first case, that is for HF1, you get FLQ1/A1 the whole square, that is V square, you will get it as 28.2528. And when you are considering the second case, you will get, when you are considering HF2 is equal to 4FL2V² / 2GD2, you get FLQ2/A2 the whole square, that is V square. One more unknown is also there, that is D2 is also unknown. You will get this as equal to 47.088. So now what you can do is, see, you can take this as equation number 1, this as equation number 2, this as equation number 3. Now you can divide equation 1 by equation 2. when you divide equation 1 by equation 2, you will get, see, you have F, L, right? You will get Q by Q1. So, Q square by Q1 square. You will get the equation in terms of Q square by Q1 square is equal to 2.8125. So, from which you will get Q1 is equal to 0.596Q. Now, you can use the equation Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2, from which you get Q2 is equal to 0.404Q. Now, you can divide equation 2 by 3. So, dividing equation 2 by 3, you get you can substitute all the values, whatever you have found in the previous steps, you will get D2 is equal to 0.5125 meter, that is equal to 51.25 centimeter. So, this is a practice problem for you. Just I have given you the outline. Solve this problem. So, if you understand this problem, you can do all the other problems also. So, thank you for today. With this, our third module has been completed. We will start the fourth module in our next class. Thank you. Thank you for listening.